In today's video, we return to the topic of false advertising for more legal risks to be aware of and more tips that we can give you. Now, our law firm is getting so many questions related to these kinds of issues that, you know, we're going to continue our series on false advertising, including the California Business Professions Code Section 51, as well as federal law, and we're going to delve into more of the legal requirements from these different codes. My name is Michael H. Cohen, and I'm founding attorney of Cohen Healthcare Law Group. In this video, we will uncover more of the rules and regulations that pertain to false advertising by healthcare businesses and practices. By the end of this video, we want you to know more about how to protect yourself from legal risk than you already know today. States beyond California have similar statutes too, so even though we're talking about California, we do represent people in different jurisdictions and hope that you'll find these lessons applicable no matter where you are. We've handled over 1,000 healthcare industry clients with similar issues. Now, a very important consideration for your advertising is that if your advertising and marketing makes any mention of the cost of goods or services you provide, it must fully disclose any variables or factors that can change those costs and fees. In fact, certain phrases are specifically banned in price advertising, like as low as. If you include price advertising in your marketing, you must be ready to provide verifiable data to back it up. Next, you have to be cautious of making scientific claims because the California Code disallows scientific claims in advertising that cannot be substantiated by reliable, peer-reviewed, published scientific studies. If you make a scientific claim about your product or treatment that's not supported by the scientific literature as described by the statute, you're entering dangerous waters, which could well be deemed false advertising. Another important note concerns use of a testimonial or statement from somebody else in your marketing. Even if the language is somebody else's and clearly indicated that it was somebody else, it is part of your advertisement and will be evaluated as if you had made the language up yourself. So that means everything we talked about so far in this video and other videos on false advertising can apply to your testimonial content, from making scientific claims to mentioning your prices. All of this could potentially be false and misleading, whether expressly or by omission. We hope the legal insights in this brief video have helped you with more of your questions on advertising and marketing legal concerns in your healthcare business. Of course, a lot of rules like these will have specific kinds of exceptions and exceptions to the exceptions, and there's still more rules that we can't possibly cover in all of our videos. However, any health and wellness business can benefit from having an experienced healthcare attorney evaluate their website and marketing materials for potential legal risks that we can work to help you mitigate. If you'd like to get in touch with us or a member of your healthcare team, please reach out to the link below. You can send us a message there or schedule an appointment. Here's to your business success. We look forward to helping you.